Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and this is a second example for a quick introduction to states and state transitions. This particular example is something near and dear to computer science people's hearts, and that is to recognize an identifier. You have to define what the identifier is, and so this is a simplified definition of what is an identifier. An identifier in this example is defined as one or more characters from this set A to Z, and I'm just doing the lowercase a to Z just for simplification, followed by zero or more characters from either that set of letters or that set or this set of digits. Okay, so that's what makes an identifier. So let us start with the state transition diagram. When I enter my state transition diagram, so there's the arrow to indicate an entry state. At this point right here, I have not yet identified any character, any identifier. I've not yet recognized an identifier in my string. Now, if I have a single character, so here's my input, that's coming from this set A through Z, so that could be A or B or dot, 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 or Z. That case, I'm now in a state where I possibly have an identifier, right? An identifier is one or more from this state. So let me circle that to indicate I have success. If I have a single character from this letter set, starting from an initialization state, I've successfully identified an identifier right there. Now, the identifier, if the input continues with characters from this set, I can have zero or more characters from this set right here, and I still have an identifier. So if I'm sitting in this state and I have zero characters from this set right here, I have an identifier. That's why I have these two circles. If I have another character from that set, I still have an identifier. So this is the input A, B, dot, 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 Z. Okay? So that's a zero more A through Z. Also, if I have zero or more from the set 0, 9, I will be in that set as well. So let me do 0, 1, dot, 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 9. Okay? So that puts me in this set right here where I have successfully found an identifier. Okay, now, let's see. There are other symbols in our alphabet that I've just not listed here. So let me just call all those other symbols other. So the set other means there's no intersection with A to Z, not from A to Z, and not from 0 to 9. So any other character. Okay, so let's take a look and see what happens if we have one of these other characters coming in. If I start in the initial state and the character that's coming in is from 0 to 9, then I do not have an identifier, right? 0 dot 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 9. So I go to this state right here where I will terminate with a fail. So it's a fail state. Also, if I have anything from the other set, I will terminate in the fail state. Here, if I have anything in the other set, that means that is not an identifier, and where I want to end up right here is done. So I'm going to label this OK, and this one is fail. So if I add another character on here, I would go to the fail state. So if I'm trying to transition out of this state over to the fail state, that means that that new character should not be included in the successful identifier that I found right here. Okay, so that's my second example of recognizing an identifier.